Hi guys, a very good morning to everybody. Today we are going to talk about current affairs for April 17th, 2019. It's 8 a.m. in the morning and I'm out with the current affairs for today in the morning tales. Well, Chesta is on a leave, so it leaves me no choice but to come out with the current affairs for you guys because I don't want to break the momentum that we have created. A lot of students have been asking me, sir, why did we stop current affairs daily update at 8 a.m. in the morning? So I've decided to create it on my own. So without wasting any time, let's move on to the current affairs for today. The first question that we are going to discuss is, India has signed an MOU with which country in the field of renewable energy, focusing on offshore wind energy? If you know the answer, provide it in the comment section below so that I know that you guys are answering regularly. And the answer to this question is Denmark. Well, if you don't know where Denmark is, here is the chart for you. Here is the map for you where you can see that Denmark is just beside Copenhagen, just beside Sweden. There you can see that is the Denmark. So Narendra Modi and Denmark, India and Denmark through RPM have decided to focus on renewable energy with the focus on offshore wind energy. So the focus is on offshore wind energy. And the letter of intent for establishment of Indo-Danish Center of Excellence for Renewable Energy in India is the letter of intent that has been created. Not very important though. For phase one, probably just the first information is important, that is with which country India signed an MOU. Now, the thing is that RBI has been and various other examinations have been asking regularly questions on MOUs. Therefore, all the important MOUs at least need to be done and remembered. Okay, so let's come to the second question. More interesting, where is India's first interactive and exotic bird park launched? A very important question, I would say, and high chances of this question coming in the examination. The answer to this question, if you know it, put it in the comment section below so that I know that you guys are engaged and involved in the daily quiz in the morning that we are coming out with. So the answer to this question is Mumbai. And what is the name of that bird park? I think that's important. The name is SL World Bird Park. So you need to remember that as well. And it is created by SL World Leisure Private Limited. I think that's very important. That's another question that's out there that can be asked in the examination. The park is home to 50 species of volant, terrestrial and aquatic birds. And it is the which is the largest theme park in Asia. Which is a water park. The name is Water Kingdom Park, which is also in Mumbai, and it is the largest theme water park in Asia. So that's another question. Three questions created out of one information, one news item. The first one was, where is it located? Second is, what is the name of the company which is created and the name of the park as well? And largest water park in Asia, that's also in Mumbai. Okay, let's come to the third question. Which of the following transport aircraft will replace the Avro fleet of Indian Air Force? A very important question. Such factual questions have also been asked in the examination. If you know the answer, please put it in the comment section below so that I know. Repeating again that you guys are engaged, you guys are continuously answering questions before me answering them. That's very important. The name of the this particular transport aircraft is C-295. Okay, and it will replace the Avro fleet of Indian Air Force. That's also important. Okay, so that's it for this particular question. Let's move to the next one. Which of the following is the indigenously designed subsonic long range missile? Indigenously designed means designed in India, and it's a subsonic long range missile. Well, all these missiles that I have put here, all these names that I've put here are actually missiles only. So that might confuse you a little. The name of the missile is Nirbhaya, and it was tested successfully from Orissa's coast by ISRO. So the next question is, created by which organization? The answer is ISRO. And the first question was, what is the name of the subsonic long-range missile? That is Nirbhaya. Okay, I hope you have understood it. A lot of phase one factual questions coming out there. The next question is, which country has designed world's first amphibious drone boat called as marine boat? A very important question. I believe such questions can be asked in the examination. A lot of factual questions we are taking today. There will be some analytical questions also, which are going to be very important, especially from RBI, Nabard and Sebi's point of view. Which country has designed world's first amphibious drone boat? The answer to this question, if you know it, put it in the comment section below. The answer to this question is China. It is the world's first amphibious drone boat, known as marine boat or also known as marine lizard, which can lead land and sea assault. So that's important. Amphibious. What is the meaning of amphibious? A particular mammal or a particular animal or a particular creature which can go into water and can also move out on the land, on land. So that's the idea. First amphibious drone boat, marine boat or marine lizard. Okay, let's come to the next question. Harshil Dani has been associated with which sport? Well, if you can see the picture out there, you would probably be able to answer it without me telling you. Okay, the answer to this question is A, badminton. Okay, the answer to this question is A, badminton. And why is he in news? He's in news because he's won the 20th Victor Dutch International Badminton title 2019. Okay, another question, Dutch International title, Victor Dutch International title, related with which sport? Badminton. Who's won it this time? Harshil Dani. What is his rank in the entire world? Not very important because it's not so good. 111th position in the world. More questions that can be asked. World number one in badminton presently. If you know the answer, put it in the comment section below. That's the question for the day that I'm asking you guys. Okay, so who is the world number one in both men and women category, male and female category, when it comes to badminton? You need to answer that question for me. Let's come to the last question for today, which is the most analytical and at the same time the most important for both phase one and phase two when it comes to RBI, Nabard and SEBI. Okay, so the question is, what is the rate of growth of exports for 2018-19 as per Ministry of Commerce? Let me have your answers and I'll be giving out some more information related to Ministry of Commerce data which has been released on exports. The answer to this question is 8%. See, 8%, that is the rate of growth of exports in India in the financial year 2018-19. Some more important information. What is the absolute number or absolute value of exports from India in the year 2018-19 in terms of dollars? The answer is $535 billion. Another question, what is the overall trade deficit of India in the year 2018-19? $176 billion. Another question, what was the trade deficit, overall trade deficit in the year 2017-18, $162 billion. These three questions can be asked. You might be feeling that 2017-18 is not important, but yes, it is important. That kind of questions can also be asked, or the improvement or the rise in trade deficit. That's the most apt word. Rise in trade deficit can also be asked. The answer to this question is $14 billion, from $162 billion to $176 billion. That's the overall trade deficit. We have the exports at $535 billion. And what is the growth in exports in this financial year compared with the previous financial year? 8%. Okay, so all these things are very important for the examination. They can be asked both in phase one as well as phase two for RBI, SEBI and NABARD, all three examinations. Okay, so that's it for today's current affairs. I hope you liked it, and we'll soon be coming out with another series where we might try and cover current affairs before 8 a.m. Okay, so we'll have the quiz at 8 a.m. but we'll have a lot of current affairs being covered before 8 a.m. as well, so that you're able to relate with all these quizzes that are being created. And the purpose is also that before you pick up the newspaper, you cover these kinds of current affairs so that your coverage of newspaper is better, your coverage of newspaper is smarter, and at the same time, you're putting in less energies because we are putting in that energies for you. So I hope you guys liked it. If you did, subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to press the bell icon, because only then will you get the notifications regarding our future videos. All the very best. Take care.